Okay, looks like that wheel up there opens the gate. Not that we can reach it or anything. Well, you could start by burning off this crud. No grappling up that way. Why don't you look around, see if there's a way to lift this lift?
Brother, did you notice the dwarves of the camp were twice as alarmed to see Brock than they were to see you?
They did seem surprised.
All right. Now I can turn this crank and cap that geyser there. You just give me the signal when you're ready.
Now. Turn it.
Copy that.
Turn it again.
Aye, aye.
Once more.
Aye, aye. Look around. Find an angle. Ain't this what you do?
Again.
Hey, I got the crank covered. You do the other stuff.
Ah, promising.
Yeah. They're up there! Take that nest out so the thing can move. That's why we're up here, remember? Old Croc to the rescue!
Watch your left!
To the fort. Come on, the lady's waiting. Hey, got another riddle for you. What gets bigger the more you take away from it?
Well, let's see. Something abstract, I expect. Appetite? No, that doesn't work.
Stump the stump.
Oh, isn't that clever?
Some for the lady.
Grab some what? The wind?
No, you idiot. The sound of the wind.
How?
Watch and learn. See? Dwarven magic's all about the intangibles. The relationship between the stuff what you can touch and what you can't. It's about understanding.
Understanding what?
The nature of a thing's more important than the form of a thing. Hang on! I smell trouble. Hey! Call an old pecker drip!
I'm here, incoming!
Over here!
Lad, join them!
So this lady, then?
The lady of the forge. Ain't a more magical creature in this whole realm. Why, I've been waiting for my chance to meet her since I was knee-high to a Noken. But Sindri'd never have it. Said I was too uncouth. But today's finally the day. Woo! I got goosebumps on my bunions.
Why, bro, I've never seen you so... Everin, are you nervous?
What? Shut up! No!